This video is a short demonstration and overview of Dynamics 365 Marketing, all about the outbound marketing capability. I'm going to show you how you can create a segment from your Dynamics 365 contacts using all of the data that's available to you in your CRM system without any integration, how to create an email using a drag and drop editor, and then how we bring those things together in a customer journey to send those emails out, and then the metrics and insights that you get as a result of that. My name's Lisa Crosby. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel if you get value out of this content. The thing to understand about Dynamics 365 Marketing is that it is sitting on the same platform as Dynamics 365 Sales, Customer Service, Field Service, any of those applications, which means that these accounts and contacts tables are exactly the same accounts and contacts tables that you work in with those other applications. So you don't need to move your data around, you won't get any delays or anything, and anything that you've created there, all of the data that you've collected, any of the custom attributes or custom fields you've created are all available to the marketing application. So let's start by creating a segment and we'll have a look at what that means. Two ways to create segments in Dynamics 365 Marketing. We have a static segment. Static segment is where you want full manual control over who is in the list. You might start by searching for a bunch of people and then say, I also want these three people here and add them in. Static segment will not change when you go away and do other things. It will only have whoever you've put in it and saved at that given moment. You can come back and take people out. You can come back and put people in. We don't use those as much, but there are some good use cases for that kind of thing. For instance, if you've got a VIP list where you want to handpick who's in there, or perhaps you just don't have the underlying data that's reliable enough to be sure that you can have a query running and that it will always pick up the right people. So that will allow you to have that full manual control over that. The other type of segment that we've got in here is called a dynamic segment, and this is more commonly used. A dynamic segment will be running a query constantly in the background, and at any given moment, whoever in that database fits the criteria of that query will be in, and if they don't fit the criteria of that query, they're out. Let me take you through some examples here. So you'll see we've got some templates that make it nice and easy to get us started and to give you examples of the kinds of things that you can do here. There are three ways that we can build a segment. The first one is with behavioural data. So things that are about what the person has done. Have they clicked on an email? Did they fill out or submit a form? We've got demographic data in here. So for instance, the information about the people, where do they live, their gender, their age, their income, those kinds of things. And then we've also got firmographic data, that next level up. They work for a company in a certain industry or in, you know, financial services or nonprofit scenarios where you've got people grouped into households. They are a member of a household which has certain properties associated with it, and we can use all of that for segmenting. I am going to skip the template and go into a blank segment here to show you how this works. So we build our segment with a combination of query blocks, behavior blocks, and segment blocks. The query block is the main starting point for these things, and we can go in and choose what we want this to be. So we've got, for instance, here a contact. That's who we're sending it to. What attribute needs to be true for that contact for them to fit into this segment? Now, this gives us all the list of all the fields on contact. The easiest way to find the one you want is to simply type it in. So I might say the city is, and I can put something in here. Let's say the city is Sydney. And because it's a text field, I can just type in text. The options here are also giving me things related to text. It is in, contains, begins with, or whatever. If I use a numerical field, currency, date, those kinds of things, I'll get something different. Perhaps we just want new customers, you know, people who are in Sydney who've joined the database after a certain time. So we could go in here and add another attribute, and this time I'm going to find that created on, which is the date that they've landed in here. So we can choose that. We can say created on is, and you'll see I've got some different options here. So this allows me to say is on or after, and I could just put in a calendar date of when that is. I can also choose relative dates in here too. So we can say, you know, is within the last 12 months or something like that. So we can go in here and choose a relative date. And we've got this cute little sliding scale in here that allows me to choose things for, you know, sort of within 12 months ago or something like that. So we can do all sorts of things with the segmenting here, and whatever we come up with, we've got these two things combined with an and, or we can combine them with an or, depending whether we want both to be true or either to be true. So you continue to build your query as complex or as basic as you want it to be. Now remember that we can combine queries. We can add a segment block in here. So I could go in and add another query that I've made earlier. I can go in and say, look for a segment, and let's bring in, for instance, something else. And this could be, you know, people who attended a certain webinar, for instance. So you can actually create segments as building blocks and combine them together into specific segments. Once you've built out a segment, give it a name. So we'll call this Sydney Webinar, save it. Now, the other thing in dynamics marketing is we always need to make things live in order to use them in other parts of the system. So once we've got that going there, we can check for errors and we can go live, and that will go through and find people in the database who match that criteria. So we've created our segments, that's defining who we're sending things to. Now let's create the actual content that we're sending. We go here into marketing emails and click new to start a new email. Now, there's a range of email templates here that you can use to get started. I'm going to click skip and just start with a blank one here. As you use marketing, you can certainly create your own templates, and that's a really good idea to do that because you don't want to be creating the same formats over and over again. So this is a drag and drop editor. I can create different section types here. I can put a single column layout in here, or 1 to 2 column layout in here. I drag my elements onto the screen here, so I can drag an image into this place and select an image from my image library. I can drag text in here as well, and also buttons and links to all sorts of other things. It's a fairly easy experience. We go through and put all of those things together. Once we've got somewhere with it, it comes up looking something like this. So here's a sample email here where I'm working with my fictional company here, Fabricam, which is selling some furniture. I've brought in some nice images, a logo, different things in there as well. Now, the thing we can do here as well is set up A/B testing. So what I've got over here is version A and version B of this email. An A/B test can be done based on the subject and the sender of the email. If you want to change those things, we can do an A/B test based on the content of the email, or the whole thing. You can have two completely different emails. So I've got an active test set up here, which is using a different word in the subject line, the word bespoke versus the word custom. So here's my subject line: have you considered bespoke design? If I go into version B, then you'll see that I've changed the subject line, custom design for your unique space. And so that's what we're going to do to test which one of those will work. And we do that inside the customer journey. And if you want to get fancier with your email design, there's a bunch of other things you can use here. You can bring videos in. Your videos do need to be hosted on an external provider. We've got the ability to bring code snippets. You can switch across into HTML to do that kind of editing there as well, if you like. And then we have built-in preview and test functionality, which allows you to see what the thing will look like. We've got a basic test in here for tablet, mobile, landscape, those types of things. And there's built-in capability with a third-party service called Litmus, which allows you to get very granular down to specific email clients and so on. We've also got some checkers built in here. So we've got the accessibility checker. Make sure you don't have things that are sort of too high contrast or color issues in your text, so that your email is accessible to as many people as possible. And also a spam checker that you can run to help you make sure that your email is going to be delivered. We can also do a test send in here so that you can check that it's going to the right place. And you'll see that I'm personalizing this, previewing it as a certain person. We can also personalize the content a little bit. So if I go in here, I can put in something like "for you" and put in the person's name. So let's just tidy that up a little bit here. And I can go in here and then click this personalization button. You can use exactly the same concept in the subject line if you like. So this allows us to bring in something like the person's first name to address them directly. So we're going to say we want to bring in here dynamic content from the contact. I just want to have something on the contact, but you'll see there we can reach into some of those other related tables. And I'm going to bring in the first name. insert that. And then when I go in and have a look at my preview and test, now previewing it as me as a contact, it's picking up my first name there so that we can see that that's all good. When we're done, we save, and we also click go live on that email to make it available to use in our customer journey, which is the next step. Customer journey is the moment that we bring it all together. We've set up our who we want to send it to in our segment. We've sent up the what we want to do in the email, and now we're going to bring it together in the journey, which is the how. Number of templates available for you there to help you get started. I'm going to skip that and start with a blank one here. Now, first thing we do, who do we want to send this out to? We set that audience. A couple of options here. We can use the segment that we created earlier, so we can go in here and look for that segment in here and find it in there. You'll notice this says inclusion. So we've also got the ability to exclude certain segments from here. So in addition to combining segments earlier, we can also do that here by saying send to this segment, but exclude this other segment. We can also choose someone who updated their contact information can trigger a journey, or someone who submitted a form. So if you've got a form hosted here, and this is another capability in Dynamics Marketing, that you can create a web form, and when someone submits that form, that can be hosted on your website or it can be hosted on a Dynamics 365 landing page, that can trigger the journey without them needing to be in a segment. We've also got the ability within segmentation here to use what's called a subscription list. So we also have the ability to set up different types of subscriptions. You will have seen this on any marketing email when you go to click manage my preferences, that idea of saying, yeah, I want to be in or out of the monthly newsletter or those kinds of things. We've got capability in there to set all of that as well. So we might decide to set this journey to say we want to communicate with people who've opted into a certain type of marketing communication. For now, I'm going to go with the segment. So we'll go in here and we will find our Sydney segment that we created earlier. And then what we can do is choose what we want to send out. So typically here we might choose the email that we want to send. So I will find that Fabricam email that we were working with before to tell them about our wonderful new furniture design that's in here. Now, because we set up an A-B test for this email earlier, we'll see the little A-B has popped up here. We can go in here and enable A-B testing and have a look at the details. If we've got more than one A-B test set up on the email, we can choose it here. We can also choose what the distribution is. So it will start typically with something like distributing it to 10% of each version, but you can slide that scale up depending on how you want to do it. You can choose your winning metric. Is it the open rate or the click-through rate? How long do you want to run the test for? And then which one to send out if the results are inconclusive. From there, we can add other things into the journey. So we might want to have a branch based on if this happened or this didn't happen. So for instance, if in that email, did someone click or open something? So we can go in here and say from that email, which is what we've set in the journey there, has it been opened? Has a link been clicked? Has a specific link in the email been clicked? We might only care about the particular thing that we wanted to care about there. We're going to wait up to 3 hours for that. If yes, then let's send another email in here. But we might want to wait a little while before we send the next email. So we can put either wait for, which is the ability to say, let's set a duration and let's wait for, you know, 1 week or 1 day or whatever that is. Or we've got the ability to add a wait until a certain date, perhaps as a launch event, and we don't want that next email to go out until the next date. And so on and so forth, and you build out this journey along the way. You can also add tasks in here. So this goes directly back to the sales application, so we can put in an appointment phone call task. We might say if someone's clicked through a certain number of things, we want to assign a task to the account manager or the person looking after that that contact to give them a call and follow up, and that will go straight back into the CRM. So let's now have a look at the analytics and what happens as a result of all of this good work. So here's what the journey looks like after it's been running. We end up with this lovely way of being able to see the paths of where everyone went through. So we can see that 22 people went into this journey. We have a bunch of people who've opened yes or no, pretty much 50-50 split there, and the subsequent steps that happened. Now, anywhere along this journey, if for instance we say, let's grab all of the people who got this far, you know, they clicked right through on this last email here, we can click through here and we can see some of the properties of what's going on, and we can actually grab this little icon here, and that's create a segment. If I click on that, that will quick create a segment of everyone who's processed at that step and then we can use that somewhere else in the application. So we've got those insights sitting in here to see what's gone on inside that journey. We also have insights on the email. So we've got here information about the total number of deliveries, unique opens, clicks, and so on, and nice little timeline chart in there. Information about the delivery and interactions, which will give you a full list of the people and who did what. We've also got links in here. So this will give us a heat map of what happened and how many people clicked on those things. Open times, so we can see what time of the day our customers are opening. And in fact, in the journey, there's a smart scheduling option that you can just toggle on to say, send the email in the preferred time of the customer so that they receive it based on their past history. And of course, A-B testing, which we did in here, so we get to see the results of our A-B test. Now, I sent this one out to kind of a large proportion of my very small sample, and they behaved in a very 50-50 kind of way here. So the A-B test wasn't able to determine which was the stronger email. It's inconclusive. It sent out version A to the rest of the people in there. And the other thing is that you look at the contact record. So now this becomes available to everyone using the system. This becomes available to your sellers. They don't have to be working with the marketing system. They get this insights tab and they can see what's gone on here. So we get this overview of all of the different things that the person has done. We've got information here about the different kinds of form submissions and things and interactions. Subscription list interactions, email open times as well, so we can see what's going on. So this really tightly connected experience between sales and marketing, which makes it very easy for the sellers to get the information and work with all of that kind of data. Now, that's pretty much the core components of working with Dynamics 365 Outbound Marketing. We've looked at segments, emails, and customer journeys, but there is actually quite a lot going on here. We have subscription management. We have event management. We can build landing pages and forms. We have the ability to do lead scoring, to track visits to your website. Lots more going on here. I hope that's been helpful. Thanks for watching.